Right.
Sit down. Have some food. Have a drink. Thank you for joining us. It's hot, which is, you know, unusual. Hi. So, I thought I would just start out a little bit about why we're here. So I'm Ingrid here, and I'm the editor of Feather Press. And for those of you who aren't familiar with us, we're a small independent women's press that started last year. And we're dedicated to publishing poetry and prose by women. And we also aim to create a thriving and supportive community through the events and workshops and publications that we put out. So we, the reason we started the press is because in this community, we've been here for many years, we've noticed that women need a lift when it comes to publishing. So that's why we're here. And in the last year, we've gone about kind of community building in a few ways. We became chapter members of Women Who Submit. Who's heard of Women Who Submit? Yes, okay. So we have monthly submission parties, which basically we get together and we look at all of the open calls for submissions, and then we collectively submit our work to various places. And we've who's been published that's gone to one of our things here? Okay, yes, yes. So, if you're interested in that, please pick up a postcard in the back or talk to me and we'll get you on the email list if you'd like to come. We also held an embodied writing and yoga workshop in May, which was really about kind of nourishing our bodies and our minds in this time that's very difficult. So we're very dedicated to offering nourishment to the community if we can. And then we also curate a quarterly reading series called Birds of Paradise. And that started earlier this year as a celebration of Women's History Month, but then we realized women should be celebrated all the time, so we continued the event for the rest of the, it's a quarterly series. And so we will be included in this year's Lit Crawl. And so on Saturday, October 14th, you can hear Jennifer and Holly Hardy and Denise Benavides, E.K. Keith and Saida Hafiz all read at the next Birds of Paradise. And then, more importantly, tonight, I stand up here as editor in front of this beautiful book. Saporoso. I tried to do it in my best Italian accent, which I'm Scottish, so you know. But this book contains not only words that are delectable and mouth-watering, but it contains a few of Jennifer's family's sacred recipes, which I really encouraged her to write down, because, you know, one of the first memories I have of Jennifer, we've been friends for many years, but one of the first memories I have of her family is their willingness to include me at their family gatherings during the many years I was orphaned in New York around the holidays, and her mother stuffed mushrooms and sauce were something that I invite you all to try to make them because the recipes are in here. And, you know, I think what she's doing here is recording some familial history that was not written down. And if we don't write it down, we lose it, because all of these were just, you know, passed down. Oh, here, put a little this and a little that in. But now they're written down. So there's also three new poems. So, yes. So I'm very proud of this book. We are missing one key ingredient, and that is our wonderful and talented friend Lam Kong, who did all of the artwork that you see in the book. And Lam and Jennifer have taken many trips to Italy together, and Lam lived there for a number of years, and he studied art. And he, like Jennifer, is also an amazing cook. But I invite all of you to take a look at the cover art is there. Do not touch it.
Okay.
For fear of the wrath of Jennifer Barone, but please take a look at it. And yeah, so I'm going to read a couple of poems. And thank you all for coming. Let's see. I pulled out a really silly one from the vault. Nutella. Forbidden in my house, I eat it straight out of the jar. I lick the spoon with lazy submission, re-dipping into rich, creamy bites. By the end of this day, an empty vessel is all that remains. Oh yes, Nutella. I have obscene and tawdry plans. I'll spread you thinly on toast, plunge cookies into your open rim, coat my lips with hazelnut divinity. Nutella on toes, knees, and fingers, my own coup d'etat platter, the chocolate rapture to the cravings of my soul. One of the food groups in Italy, morning croissants sliced open, pregnant with a hazelnut dream. Nutella will entrance you, like a siren from the cupboard, a lascivious woman undulating and in dancing her way inside your moist. If my body is yours, what would I become in your hands? Would you flatten and roll me between palms, sculpted into the soft arc of a sourdough loaf? If my blood was the ink of your pen, what would I become spread out onto paper? Would you write about curvature, a longing for roundness in a world full of angles? Would you dream of a summer peach, tender, fuzzy skin, the sweet drizzle in your mouth during the long nights while the Santa Anas glow? Could I see the wonder of the world in the small continent of your bed? Would I be haunted by prisms, followed by the body's memory on a foggy night, high above the skyline, under the purr of a sleeping city? If I was stitched into a quilt, what colors would arise? Would I be sewn by hand and left alone on the foot of a bed, awaiting a warm body to lie oneself underneath? The bathtub listens to the rain of the water, calls out for my touch under the spray. All is ripe with possibility. Jennifer asked me to read this poem. This is from the first book that we put out. Dear summer, love is diagonal, not unlike the whir of a machine, buzz of an insect, mad dash of Canadian geese in the running bath. I step off the curb, 15 seconds later, two cars crumple like used Kleenex, my legs free to continue walking down the street as sirens flood the night's quiet. When two people traveling on varied paths directly miss one another, is it an omen of good luck or bad? The soccer player kicks the ball to bend into the net, the way the light bends into a rainbow's curve. He gazes across a crowded bar as if only I exist. I recall my first softball glove, how unexpectedly delicious the leather hide smelled of something nearly briny but not the sea. The giant ball lands directly in my palm, but love is not something to be caught. Minutes tick away, a letter arrives and proclaims to be love or lost love or who the hell knows. We write to one another about mystery and longing and ghostly characters who survive the sweaty summers of the New York City asphalt. Condensed sweat drips from air conditioners, a rain of rapture down from concrete heavens. Machines purr in bedrooms of lonely women and pull out orgasms like hot pasta, wet, steaming noodles.